Good morning, music fans. This is Ron of the Ronnie Record Show. I'm without my wife today, my beautiful wife, Karen. I'm sorry about that. I know you all miss her. She's your favorite. So you're stuck with me this morning. But hopefully you're going to enjoy the show. I'm going to talk about the rock and roll roots, where a lot of it came from, and I'm saying the main source to me. I'm going to play music out of the 40s. That led to rock and roll, not the 50s. I give a lot of credit to Fats Domino. 1950, he did the Fat Man, which was, I think, the first rock and roll record. Also, Lloyd Price was in there, 50-51, with Lottie Miss Claudie. I'm going to go back to the 40s only, though. So this is, what you're listening to right now, is Lionel Hampton. And Lionel Hampton was the king of the vibraphone, you know, where you hit the little thing on the vibes, and he was awesome, big band leader. This is Hamp's Boogie, and as you know, I really believe that Boogie Woogie is the heart of early rock and roll. Just listen to that beat. It's a dance beat, and that's what early rock and roll was about. The next song, this one is Louis Jordan. I don't know whether it's Louis or Louie. I never saw him in person. I didn't see anybody in person back in the 50s. But a little big band sound here. But just listen to this guy. See that beat? This is Choo Choo to Boogie. Another boogie sound. See, boogie woogie sound. Choo Choo to Boogie. The next song by Louis is another example of a great singer, performer in the rhythm and blues arena. This is Caldonia. And you might have heard this song in the 50s. I don't know. But another song out of the 40s. Always use a little humor. Kind of boogie-woogie beat. Dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun. They go up and down the scales. That's what happened a lot in early rock and roll. Going up and down those scales. Yeah, we're going to hear more brass. That wasn't really an early 50s music. But still got that sound. Kind of hear it? Anyway. Walking with my baby, she got great big feet. She's all leaning like and ain't had nothing to eat. But she's my baby. She's my baby. And I love her just the same. Crazy about that woman, cause Caldonia is her name. Caldonia. Caldonia. Hear a little Richard there a little bit? All right. Another great singer of the era was Wynonna Harris. And I don't know how to pronounce his name. I don't know. Wynonna Harris. This is good rocking tonight. Starting to use the rock term. Good rocking tonight. Come on, good rocking tonight. Elvis did a version of this song. Originally was written by Roy Brown. Who are you going to hear next? There's good rockin' tonight. See, the rock and roll words are in there. And this guy was one ladies' woman. Boy, I tell you what, ladies' man, I mean, he just loved the ladies loved him. A lot of era of drinking and women. He finally burned out, but he was very popular at the time. Good rock tonight, and then this one's Lollipop Mama by Wynonna. Hear that beat again?
I'm a big fat mama, she calls
big
me
fat mama. Hear that sax? Now that's really rock and roll. Hear it?
When she starts to love me, she never knows when to stop.
She never knows when to stop when she starts loving me. This is really rock and roll. Tell me it isn't. saxophone in the background, that early saxophone sound. Here's Roy Brown. This is Rockin' at Midnight. Little big band sound there, I know. We've been rocking at midnight, so you just got to change the words a little bit to good rocking. Good rocking at midnight. Okay. Here's another oldie but goodie, is Lucky Milliner, big band leader. That sound again, bum ba bum bum ba bum bum ba bum. That repetition that old early rock and roll used, right out of the 40s. This is the natural blues. This is the blues origin of rock and roll. Did you hear all that repetition? Dun 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 dun, up and down the scales. A little bit of sax there. Da, 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 da. This is early rock and roll, right out of the 40s. These are the early pioneers. Lovely little sax solo. Nice, huh? Really nice. All right, this is Marvin Johnson's coming up next with Hey Lottie Mama. This got a real rockin' sound. No, I made a mistake. This is Big J. McNeely, great saxophone player. That's why I picked him. This is Deacon's Hop. Sorry, Deacon's Hop, Big J. McNeely. He knew how to play the saxophone, one of the early honkin' sax sounds. That's why I picked him. Hear it? One of the early saxophone players that made it honk. Made that sax play like a rock and roll instrument, which it became. Hear that? Eventually, they would use the saxophone in the middle of the song almost all the time, like with the Coasters and all those early groups use a sax like this. Okay? No longer the sax of the 30s or 40s, early 40s. It's more of a rhythm and blues rock and roll sax. Okay, now I'm going to play you Marvin Johnson and Hey Lottie Mama. Hear it? There it is. Hear that beat? Hear that saxophone playing? Huh? That's what it is. That's early rock and roll. I hate to keep reminding you, this is the 1940s, kind of the late 1940s, but a lot of people called this junk blues at the time, opposed to the old blues, sad blues sound. They called this junk blues. I call it like rock and roll blues, really. I hope you enjoyed this show today. Give you a little bit of background of early rock and roll. Next is Joe Liggins and Pink Champagne. It's just got a little bit of that repetitive sound that early rock and roll had. A little quieter, kind of a nice song, a little saxophone in there. Then it's on to take us out of this episode of the Ronnie Records Show. anyway, I just want to give you a little taste of, I think, where it all began. That rhythm and blues track that got us to early rock and roll. I know rockabilly from the countryside contributed, but I really think the beat and that dancing thing came from the rhythm blues trunk of this tree. It came out to be rock and roll. So I'm glad you joined me this morning without my wife Karen, but she'll be back to their episodes always. Sometimes I just want to hog the screen for a little bit to tell you about some special things to me, being rock and roll, the saxophone of the early songs, you know, that rhythm and blues that provided that dance beat. Anyway, this is the Ronnie Record Show signing off today. I hope you enjoyed it. Stick around and wait till our next episode. We'll get back to the Ron and Karen part, okay? All right. Thank you very much. Have a good day.